हेलो गाइस, aglasim.com इज बैक विद सीबीएसई क्लास 12 अकाउंटेंसी एग्जाम। नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट एग्जाम पैटर्न। द टोटल टाइम अलाउड इज 3 आवर्स, मैक्सिमम मार्क्स इज 80। द क्वेश्चन पेपर विल बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, पार्ट ए एंड पार्ट बी। पार्ट ए इज कंपल्सरी फॉर ऑल, पार्ट बी हैज टू ऑप्शंस, फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट एनालिसिस एंड कंप्यूटराइज्ड अकाउंटिंग। अटेम्प्ट only one option of part B. All parts of question should be attempted at one place. Now let's talk about marks distribution. Part A consists of accounting for partnership firms and companies. Accounting for partnership firms fundamental, which consists of 10 marks. Accounting for partnership firms reconstitution and dissolution, which consists of 25 marks. Accounting for share capital, which consists of 18 marks. And accounting for debentures, which consists of 7 marks. Let's come up to preparation tips. Tips specifically for accountancy. In accountancy, try to attempt questions on company accounts, cash flow statement, and partnership first. These carry 60% weightage in the paper. Calculate each and every thing properly. Show proper working notes. You must draw up a proper format and must write narrations in case of journal. You should also go through all illustrations and give formulae for ratio analysis. How to tackle questions in the examination hall? In case of questions related to shares, if applied shares are given of shareholders, then after finding allotted shares, the students can simply cut down the applied shares from the question paper so that they can consider only allotted shares while solving the questions. While preparing cash book in shares, try to pass all the entries of bank in rough so that there is no confusion. While preparing the profit and loss appropriation account, the profit should always be before an appropriation. Also, the students should be aware about the balances of capital of partners. It should complete the entire 12 months, otherwise month consideration will be there for any appropriation. In case of redemption of debentures, the student should always try to find out which method of redemption is given in the question. Now let's talk about how to attempt class 12 accountancy exam. You are fortunate enough that you are provided with 15 minutes reading time for reading the question paper. Utilize this time at the optimum level and make best use of this opportunity before you start attempting the accounting question paper. Also check the mark assigned to each question and plan quickly. Plan to answer those questions first in which you are more confident. When you start attempting a particular question, underline the main points. Do not answer without reading the question fully and correctly. Attempt all the parts of a particular question together and serialize. It may happen that you do not know the answer of a part of a question or you are not sure about the correct answer at once. Then leave some space for that and try to attempt it in the end. Highlight the answer number properly or write them in the boxes. Ideally, you should write answer number 1 or answer number 2. This will let the paper checker see your answer quickly and easily, thus he will be able to allot marks properly. Handwriting and presentation is a very crucial part of accountancy exam. It has been seen that students who write legibly get more marks, and sometimes even in an average answer, students score good marks. So write legibly and make it easier for paper checker. Paper checker do not like cutting or mistakes in the answer sheet. It gives bad impression. Answer sheet must be presented in a neat and clean manner. Stepwise marking. CBSE follows a stepwise marking pattern for checking. Thus, if your balance sheet is not matched, even then you will get marks for the steps done correctly. Do not match the balance sheet with wrong amounts. Do not waste time during the exam, as accountancy exam will be a lengthy exam. So if you are not able to get the answer of a particular question, then instead of wasting your time on that question, utilize that time in attempting the next question. If time is left at the end, then you can try attempting the same question again. Format and accounting requirement. Format is must in accounts exam. You must follow all the formats as per the accounting rules. While making format of journal, ledger, balance sheet or any statement, use pencil, not pen. Do not forget to write debit or credit. There are few accounting requirements which you need to take care, like writing DR for the debit, CR for the credit amounts, and heading like date, particulars and amounts, working notes and rough work. show proper working notes. Wherever working notes are required, show them. They carry marks in almost all the practical questions. Rough work should be done in a separate sheet, not with the solution or the margin on the right side of the answer sheet. The most important part, balance sheet. The balance sheet should be as per the Schedule 3 of accounting methods. A question based on share capital in which you need to depict the items of a balance sheet of a company with notes under the different head has to be learned as per the new format of a balance sheet. New format of a balance sheet has some impact on comparative income statement, common size income statement, comparative balance sheet and common size balance sheet, which you have to take care. What if your balance sheet does not tally? It is a common mistake that students make while attempting the question. All you need to do is to find out difference between two sides and match that amount in the question. Then there may be two possibilities. Possibility one, any amount matches with the difference. If any amount matches the difference, then see whether you have given both the effects of a transaction properly. And if not, then show that effect and your balance sheet will be matched. Possibility two, no amount matches with the difference. If such amount is not found, then double it or make it half of that amount to find that such related figure due to which difference is coming. Remember that any figure comes from the balance sheet, then you need to show single side effect in the required account or statement because second effect of that item exists in the balance sheet itself. Make sure you do not waste time in this process. The night before the exam is very much crucial for your exam and your exam performance pretty much dependent upon that. You must not cram before the exam to follow or you should just take a review for each topics. Never think of cramming too much before the exam as it will mix your topics and you will feel low in confidence. You should sleep as soon as possible to make your brain and body to relax a bit. Never try to read or to study anything new just before the exam. Close your book 1 hour before the exam starts and feel relaxed and worry-free and full of self-confidence before the exam. Also, get up early in the morning and take another view of the important topics and formulas and format and make yourself filled with confidence as confidence is the main key to score well. Check out all the things you require during exam time, that is admit card, pencil, rubber, sharpener. Everything, whether it is small or big, matters a lot during your exam. And if you like our video, please give us a thumbs up, comment and share and subscribe to our channel. All the best, do well.
Learn more and better with uglasem.com.